Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome is an infection caused by the retrovirus, human immunodeficiency virus. Now, this disease is characterized by severe immunosuppression, making the patient susceptible to various opportunistic infections, malignancies, and neurological disorders. Now, there are two different species of HIV, HIV-1 and HIV-2. HIV-1 is the most common type of HIV causing AIDS. This species has a worldwide distribution, mostly predominating in the United States, Europe, and Central Africa. HIV-2 is mostly found in cases in Western Africa and India. So the outermost layer is the viral envelope, or the lipid bilayer, consisting of surface viral glycoproteins called GP120 and GP41. Immediately beneath the viral envelope is a matrix protein called P17. The viral core consists of P24 capsid, two copies of viral RNA, three enzymes, namely reverse transcriptase, integrase, and protease. It also consists of a nucleocapsid protein called P7 or P9. There are various different modes of transmission for the HIV virus. Sexual transmission by far makes up for the most frequent mode of infection. Intravenous drug abuses, that is by the sharing of needles, blood transfusion, organ transplantation, as well as mother to infant. This could happen in utero, during birth, or during breastfeeding. Now, the spread of HIV through saliva is not significant. This may be because there are inhibitory factors in saliva that impede the infectivity of the virus. So HIV shows a predilection for T lymphocytes, especially CD4+ T cells, macrophages, and nerve cells. The HIV virus attaches to the target cell, let's say a CD4+ T cell, via a T cell's CD4 receptor. The virus achieves this via its GP120 and GP41 surface glycoproteins. Once the attachment is successful, the viral RNA or genome gains entry into the cytoplasm of the host cell. Once inside the cell, the viral genome undergoes reverse transcription via its reverse transcriptase enzyme, synthesizing double-stranded complementary DNA. The complementary DNA then gains entry into the host nucleus and integrates itself with the host, that is the CD4+ T cell's DNA. The integrated viral genome then goes into a phase of latency. Alternatively, the viral genome integrated with the host genome directs it to form viral RNA and other viral proteins. The viral core proteins formed bud off from the host cell membrane, forming the new virus. And how does the host cell die? Well, when the virus buds off, it increases plasma cell permeability of the host, thereby killing the cell. Apoptosis of the host cell is triggered on attachment of the virus with the cell. Cytotoxic or CD8+ T cells and natural killer cells may cause death of those CD4+ T cells coated with the viral glycoproteins, namely GP120 and GP41.